First and foremost, when I give all praises to the Most High, Yahweh, Bashem, Yoshai. When I say double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone and Rule Well.
That's right.
You know that are outside it. You know, every week, every day you see our videos from the elders and pushing this word in truth and hard, sincere, you know. And to all the brothers that are outside there that are pushing the word in truth and sincerity around the world, we say Shalom.
Shalom.
So this is the topic tonight, is just that, you know, the Most High hate. And we supposed to hate the things that the Most High hate.
Okay.
We supposed to love what this world doing. So if the Most High hate certain stuff, we have to hate it as well. We can't go along with that.
This is Romans chapter 8, verse 13, chapter 12.
Verse 13?
12 verse 9.
Verse 9. Yeah. Let love be without dissimulation.
Yeah.
Abhor that which is evil.
You see, abhor that which is evil. Hate that which is evil. We're supposed to love that what is evil. So like if like we're supposed to love faggots. We're supposed to love people that sleep on animals. We're supposed to love people that are talking about other gods. Talking about, you know. We're supposed to love that. Can you say hate what is evil? He didn't say love it. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. And when you say let love be without dissimulation, that dissimulation means hypocrisy.
Yeah. Right?
That word goes back to hypocrisy.
Yeah.
And hypocrisy goes back to pretend.
Yeah.
So that's right.
You know? Yeah. So finish it up,
yeah. Yeah. Let love be without dissimulation. Mm-hmm. Abhor that which is evil.
Yeah.
Cleave to that which is good.
So cleave to that which is good. And you're supposed to cleave towards these scriptures. Cleave towards the Most High. Because they will try to find good.
Yeah.
You're going to find nothing. You gonna find nothing good in the world. Because what I'm doing evil. So you can't cleave to what the world is doing.
Yeah.
You know, it's supposed to cleave to what the scriptures say, to what the Most High, what the Most High say, and what he put out for you to follow. It's supposed, you know, matter of fact, it's supposed to cleave to the Most High, the words, the laws, statutes, and commandments.
That's right.
That we're supposed to cleave to.
Obviously.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, this is Psalms chapter 34, verse 14. Mm-hmm. Depart from evil and do good.
Say depart from evil and do good. That and that next thing is supposed to yeah, watch. If you see something in front of you evil, it's supposed to depart one time.
That's right.
Don't continue in it. Or don't follow it. You know, like all these wicked trends you be seeing like on the social media. You're supposed to be following them wicked trends. Supposed to depart from it.
God. Yeah, depart from evil and do good.
Mm-hmm.
Seek peace and pursue it.
Yes, you know, seek peace and pursue it. Seek righteousness. Seek what is good. I know continue in that which is good. Yeah, go ahead.
This is Amos chapter 5 verse 15.
Yeah.
Hate the evil and love the good.
Yeah, so that next chapter, you know what? Hate what is evil. You know, we ain't supposed to be agreeing. But what the government saying, we're supposed to be agreeing with saying pork good, that I meat, that meat healthy. You know, we're supposed to be saying, you know, yeah, go ahead and do that, you know. You're supposed to hate which, what is evil. Whether.
Yeah. Say hate the evil and love the good,
yeah,
and establish judgment in the gate. It may be that the Most High power force will be gracious unto the remnant of Joseph.
Yeah. Now you say in judgment in the gate. You know, like when you go to the street area, they tell people what is good and what is evil. Get them righteous judgment. You know?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
This is Psalms 97:10.
Yeah.
You say, ye that love the Most High, hate evil.
Say what?
Ye that love the Most High, hate evil.
Say, ye that love the Most High, hated evil. So if you really for the Most High, we're supposed to be agreeing with all the bullshit in the world. We're supposed to be loving that. We're actually supposed to hate it. Your man, if you say the Most High, hate all that bullshit. After this. Right? Yeah, so we're supposed to be loving We ain't supposed to be like these churches saying that, you know, it's you ain't supposed to be judging these bull men, these faggots. You know, it's not you for the judge. If you Mosai say you hear that, and you fall any Mosai, you supposed to hear that as well.
Go on.
Go ahead.
Yeah. He said, he that loved the Most High, he hate evil.
Yeah.
He preserved the souls of his saints.
Yeah.
He delivered them out of the hand of the wicked.
And he preserved his soul. He preserved his soul of his saints. Like them who actually will cleave to the good. You know, they're not them who will do wickedness.
Sirach chapter 15 verse 13, he said the Most High hated all abomination.
Yeah, he said he hated all abomination. So if the Most High say he hate all abomination, you know the man, the Lord, the ark, what he say about them? If I get a little bit of concern, yeah, so if the Most High say he hate all abominations, we supposed to hear that as well.
Well, have a piece of prayer now.
This is
Psalms 34 verse 16.
Yeah.
He said the face of the Most High is against them that do evil.
Yeah, if read so like yeah, that's not read for me.
The face of the Most High is against them that do evil.
Yeah.
To cut off the remembrance of them from the earth.
To cut them off. That when you say two thirds of Israel, they're cut off. Because 2/3 of the people actually, and they're doing the Most High evil.
Because they have no fear.
Yeah, they have no fear.
And I have a piece of concern now too.
Yeah.
Right, the Proverbs chapter 8, verse 13.
Yeah.
So the fear of the Most High is to hate evil.
The fear of the what?
The fear of the Most High is to hate evil.
The fear of the Most High is to hate evil.
Pride.
Yeah, go ahead, pride.
And arrogancy.
Yeah.
And the evil way. And the fraud mouth do I hate.
And the evil way. So they all go back that, you know what, the fear of the Most High is to really hate evil. We ain't supposed to be loving that. Once it's evil, you ain't supposed to say, you know what, we can't judge that. No. We're supposed to hate it one time. One time. You can't be the truth and somebody come and tell you something evil and you playing it off like, you know, yeah, you know, thing. Nah, I bullshit. So to tell them one time, hey, that bullshit, boy. That bullshit. Yeah, they hear that.
Yeah, there is Sirach 15:13. He said, the Most High hated all abomination, and they that fear the Most High love it not.
He said, yeah, that go back to it. Once you fear the Most High, you love not evil. You wouldn't be in this. You wouldn't love. Yeah, watch me. You wouldn't love what the world doing. Cause what the world doing, it's actually they do nothing good. They do nothing good. It have nobody in the world are doing anything good. Yeah.
It Proverbs chapter 3 verse 7.
Yeah.
Be not wise in thine own eyes.
Yeah.
Fear the Most High and depart from evil.
See, and depart from what?
Evil.
And depart from evil. Straight out. I will tell you. Hate the things that the Most High hate. Don't go and love it. Don't be wise in your own sight and say, you know what, boy? I could say that okay. And the Most High won't know because he knows everything. He knows everything.
Proverbs chapter 8 verse 13.
Yeah.
The fear of Yahweh is to hate evil.
Yeah, the fear of the Most High say hate evil. Right.
Pride and arrogancy.
Yeah.
And the evil way.
And an evil way.
And the fraud mouth do I hate.
And the fraud mouth do I hate. So, chapter 26.
Yeah, verse 26. While as yet he had not made the earth, nor the fields, nor the highest part of the dust of the world.
Yeah.
When he prepared the heaven, I was there. When he set the compass upon the face of the dead.
Yeah, so we were saying it's just you gotta hear the evil straight out.
The man, Nilo.
So what you're saying is that if the Most High tell you straight out that these faggots is an abomination, or you could come and tell, or you could come and say, you know where is that? Is you ain't supposed to be judging them. You ain't supposed to be you ain't supposed to be, you know what, die their life. No, it's not so. Cause city get destroyed for them. And the same thing gonna happen when the Most High come.
This is Leviticus chapter 18, verse 22.
Yeah.
Thou shalt not live with mankind,
yeah,
as with womankind.
He said, thy law. So if you had a fallen law, statute and commandments, right? And the Most High gave these laws. And you say it's okay. It's okay for two men and two women to walk. To walk, what is it, happily on the streets together. And that animal say, he hated all abomination. Yeah. And this is abomination. Let's finish it up.
Thou shalt not live with mankind as with womankind.
Yeah.
It is abomination.
It is a what?
Abomination.
So the animal say, he hated all abomination. So if you say if the abomination, right? And the Most High say he hated all abomination. You ain't supposed to love that. You ain't supposed to love that. Can you say it clean to the good way? You ain't supposed to be following that.
The First Timothy chapter 1 verse 10.
Yeah.
For among us,
yeah,
for them that defile themselves with mankind,
yeah,
for men stealers, for liars,
yeah,
for perjured persons, mm-hmm, and if there be any other thing that is contrary to some doctrine,
yeah,
according to the glorious gospel of the blessed power which was committed to my trust.
Yeah.
So when you see that among us and all of them, the abominable things, you understand? Because they defile themselves with mankind, just like how you say. Well, you just read that one there with lying, mankind lying with each other, that abomination, and one, these are the things here we know call. They are also not of your Basham Yoshai. Son, because have some of them that even lying with beasts, with horse and all them kinda abominable thing.
Can.
Son, lying not of the Most High. And so, anything there?
Yeah, what are you thinking of? What are you thinking of this? Right.
It's Proverbs, right?
Yeah.
Chapter 6, verse 16. Say, these six things though, the most I hate. Yea, seven are an abomination unto him.
I just hear that he hate all abomination. Well,
see a proud look.
A proud look.
A lying tongue.
A lying tongue. Imagine that, because with pride, you get swell headed, because it's not how much you know. You have to be humble at the same time too. Concerned. So tell some brothers in the truth. And those who in the world full of pride. And with that pride, he has even lied. Sometimes with that pride.
A proud look, a lying tongue,
yeah,
and hands that shed innocent blood.
Hands that shed innocent blood, because really and truly, right now, we have to wait until Yahushua return to do anything. Understand? We can't kill your brothers. Understand what?
Say, and heart that devises wicked imaginations.
A heart that devises wicked imaginations. Because there are some wicked niggas out here. They will just sit around and think about real unrighteousness, real wickedness. You understand? Like, I wonder who I could go and rob today. You know? And you're robbing your own brother?
Can.
You understand? Most of you like that. Well.
Yeah. See, and heart that devises wicked imaginations, feet that be swift and run into mischief.
From the time, he said feet that be swift. To go towards mischief, right? Somebody come to tell you something which have no profit in your Abashem or Shai, or King Scripture, they say the wisdom of this world is nothing, right? But if somebody come to tell you something like go and rob this one or rob that one, you're going with that. You know, like wickedness. You understand? Well,
yeah, see, a false, if he that be swift and run into mischief, a false witness that speaketh lies,
yeah.
And he that soweth discord among brethren.
He that soweth discord among brethren, that's a very, very serious on the court. It's our brothers who in the truth, you know, and they will come and talk with one brother here about something, and they'll go and talk to that next brother about the same thing and twist it up. Understand? So them two brothers now will be two different stories. They're going to be against each other, the squad, and so in the squad among brethren.
Right.
So you're not supposed to do that. That you're not of your Abba Hashem Yahushai. Because you're supposed to be of one mind. Understand?
Singing one song.
Right. Understand? And keeping with eyes forward to the coming of Yahushai Mashiach. To gain to that kingdom.
So, okay.
To inherit.
Yeah. And when his brothers are not doing that, right? They actually not realizing that they're doing evil.
Right.
Understand? And when they actually do that, they actually hating. You actually putting towards hate to your side. According to this piece of hate, this is John 3:20. He says, for everyone that doeth evil, hated the light, and that light is your side.
Right.
Understand? So once you continually doing evil. You understand? Or continue doing wicked stuff. You understand? You actually not only hating your brother, but you hating your washer. You understand? I'll read it again. He said, for everyone that doeth evil hated the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved.
And he said, neither cometh to the light, right? Now, if you unshift, so to speak, right? You're on shit, and you know that. You know that we are doing this wrong thing. And he said, neither come to the light. You can't face your shit again. You understand? Because, first to begin with, you know you're on shit, and you know through the scriptures, you're supposed to know that these are very serious power. Understand? So if you're on shit, you know you can't face, you can't come to that light. You can't. We won't say. If you still face it. At that time. Understand? So you can't be on that. You have one there?
Yeah. Yeah.
But
Rami is a different. Now go ahead, Brian.
Right. Because as you brother was saying too, that brothers and by constantly swing this squad and thing. Right, that is like rebelling against your Shai. You understand? This is Job 24:13. Right? You see that they are of those that rebel against the light. You understand? So they keep rebelling against your Shai. You understand? Keep rebelling against the law, statutes and commandments.
Yeah.
Right? Cool. They know not the ways thereof. Not abiding the path thereof. So they're not abiding within the path that Yahushua set. You understand? They just keep going and taking their own path.
They're doing their own thing.
You understand? Doing their own thing, taking their own path. They're not actually following the footsteps of Yahushua.
Yeah.
You understand? I mean, that they might be calling the name of the Messiah and the name of the Son. You understand? But they're actually hating on him.
Yeah.
They're actually hating on him by doing that.
Psalms 101 and 139, from verse 19 to 21. To verse 22, it says, surely thou wilt slay the wicked, O power, depart from me therefore, ye bloody men. For they speak against thee wickedly, and thy enemies take thy name in vain. Do not I hate them, O Lord, that hate thee, and am not I grieved with those that rise up against thee? I hate them with perfect hatred. I count them my enemies.
That's right. Yeah.
So even David had, you see, he hated them with, you say, perfect hatred, that he had the Mosai. Yeah. So he's saying, that's why you're not supposed to hate a man. Yes. And then King David, a man who was after, that man after the Mosai had. If you say you can't hate men with perfect hatred, and this time here, what are you supposed to be doing, mate?
And let's start to the slack, yeah? Let's start to that. Me. If I hear somebody blaspheming or making fun of my Lord, I wouldn't like that. I must hear that. You understand? So I'll blast them away the same way. Because you can't be blaspheming or talking about my Lord.
Can't. I score first.
You understand?
I score first.
I don't want that. So you can't like that man. Because in your workplaces and all, when they're talking worldly, because we're men are the most side, when they're talking worldly, they have to depart from that the same way.
Yeah.
You understand? Get Romans, that's right. Get Romans 13:14. Supposed to depart from that. Or even, why does switch it up? They talking worldly, I will come with my, I will talk about my Lord.
Yeah.
And when I talk about my Lord, they just stop talk and go about their own way.
Yeah.
This is Romans chapter 13 verse 14.
Yeah.
He said, but put ye on the Lord, Yahushua Mashiach,
yeah,
and make not provision for the flesh.
He said, make not provision for the flesh. You understand? And that was saying, because if they're talking worldly, and you go and join with them, and talk about what I'm talking, you're making provision for the flesh.
Can.
Like being carnal.
Yeah, because you're just talking around to the arm.
You understand?
You're
not supposed to make no wait for that flesh, or that worldly talk.
Can.
No, don't make no provision for that. That way you have to always keep the most of your Basham, your Shai. In the thoughts, you always have to be thinking about
evil. Meditating.
Meditating on this word.
Yeah,
you understand? So, as I say, when they come with them worldly talk, I just switch it up, I just talk about my Lord. Or I depart from it and move away. You understand? You're not supposed to make no provision for the flesh. Don't get caught up in their thinking. Don't be, because we're not like them.
That's right.
You understand? We're men are the most high ambassadors.
Come.
You understand? For your Basham, your Shai. You make a provision for the flesh. Do get caught up in that worldly thinking and join in with them and talk about this one, how much you look at brush and all them. Don't make no provision for that, because the only thing that doing, or the thing that doing, is really taking your that cutting your meditation, because that taking your mind off of your Basham, your Shai. You understand?
Great. Everybody check it, right? Let me say ambassadors for certain companies and things, certain establishments, right? They just care about themselves a certain way,
mm-hmm,
right? They actually meet with certain people. They don't meet and talk with everybody, you
know?
Because for them, being ambassadors for a company is a high position.
Can.
You understand what I'm saying?
Can.
So they will meet and talk with certain people, you understand? And they talk other people that they wouldn't talk with.
Mm-hmm.
Because why? Those people are not on their level.
Correct.
Because they are ambassadors of a high sector for a particular company.
Can.
The same way we are with your Basham, your Shai.
With the highest.
You understand? With the highest with power.
Highest power.
The highest ambassador.
Yeah.
You understand? Can. So, therefore, we should be likewise. That's why we prefer to be around the brothers. Because we have no other people, the two-thirds and the heathens, are not on our level.
Because we could really talk with that two-thirds. We could really talk about those who don't want to take this word.
What kind of conversation
you can have? What kind of conversation you can hold?
Yeah. Exactly. Can.
The only thing that could be talking about is worldly things. Worldly conversation that we'll be having. We're not supposed to get caught up with that.
Exactly.
That's right. You have to remember, well, hey, I'm on a mission, like, I don't do what the Father sent me to do. You understand? They can't get caught up with them saying now. Because when it, as much as you know, you could also go back to a deep sleep. Yeah. That's why you're not supposed to make no provision for that.
Here's Psalms chapter 11 verse 5. Say, the Lord tried the righteous, but the wicked and him that loveth violence, his soul hated. Yeah, so you know what? The Most High does hate. And he said, if the Most High hate that, you yourself have to.
That's right.
You follow in the Most High.
Can.
He said, upon the wicked, he shall rain snares, fire and brimstone. So you know if the Most High, like all the churches say the Most High love everybody, then why he say you go rain brimstone on them? Why he destroy cities that had faggots?
And you why, know? And why he say he hate?
And why he come, and that thing, why he say he hate?
Because he can't be no shoot and he can't be no shoot. And we haven't had the Jews are forgetting them.
It can't add up.
You can't have, you need truth and you have bedrooms and forget. Oh. You understand? Because you must hear that, you're supposed to fucking hear that too.
God. Are you telling yourself, you know what? My friend she's a lesbian, but me and she's so good. Fuck it, fuck that.
Fuck that, because. And that woman has
you lost it. You lost it, this fucking death.
Can.
You're supposed to be one to kill she in your fucking mind.
Yeah, because you'll be associating yourself with that.
Exactly, because that's what's going on. You hate faggots, right? You hate faggots, but you love lesbians. That's not adding up
neither. Isaiah 13:15,
man. Understand? That's not adding up neither.
You know? Fuck you, tell me about your friend. Your friends are lesbian, a thing, but you read the Bible every day. You read it too.
Understand? Yeah. This is Isaiah 13:15.
Yeah.
Everyone that is firm shall be trust true. And everyone that is joined unto them shall fall by the sword.
And everyone that be formed with them, you wanna be accepting that your friend is a faggot or your friend is a lesbian and you comfortable with that, you know what? The same way them want dead, the same way once you join unto them, you want dead the same way.
We're talking about brothers in the truth who actually know the law concerning the faggots and thing. You understand? Everyone that is formed with again. See, everyone that is formed shall be trust true. So if you being formed with a brethren, is a faggot, understand, or a female so-called friend, is a lesbian, you can be trust true with them as well. But if you go up into your holy most I hate them, you join yourself onto them.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Even also as you brother was saying before, with conversation. You understand? That is also being joined onto them through conversation as well. You understand? Like, let's read this. It's Isaiah 8:20. He said, to the Lord, to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there's no light in them.
Because there's no light. Because all the fuck you will be in the truth and saying that it's okay.
Can.
You know? You have no light in you. Because these scriptures also wake you up. Also wake up the spirit to make you see the evil things that are outside there. Give me 1 John 3:13 there. Let's go that first one. Yeah. That the thing. Okay, if you're reading the scripture, say you're supposed to be hating this world.
Can you're not supposed to be being comfortable.
You know what? Shit, all of them that we didn't know in the world. Yeah, in the world, you want them as good, but according to this. According to the scriptures, they are your enemies.
Because they love wickedness.
You know, they are enemies for the gospel's sake. Because they love wickedness.
Yeah. 1 John 3:13. He said, marvel not, my virgin, if the world hate you.
He said, marvel not if the world hate him. Because the world must hate because we don't love the world. As Yahushua said, he said, they don't hate you. They hate me.
Yes.
You know?
It's a blessing to know people hate us. I just want you guys to know that in the truth.
Yeah,
because everyone that are going to church and thing and going in these 7 houses, nobody will hear them. So they're actually going against the scriptures. That is actually against the scriptures. Because everybody who loves a young boy who's going to church. Everybody loves a young boy who's paying tithes every Sunday. You understand? Everybody loves a young woman who's going to church and paying tithes and, you know? Everybody loves this person. So that is not according to scripture.
Because they ain't going to the so-called churches, which is the temples, they ain't going to the other houses, right? And scoffing. Or when they see us out on the highways and the byways, they'll scoff at us. But they ain't going in the other houses.
No, of course not. You understand?
And because this 1 John 4:5, right? He says, they are of the world, therefore speak they of the world.
Can.
And the world hear them.
Yeah, because they are of the world and speak things of the world. Because they don't have this knowledge. And Sam, so they know about the world, so that's all they'll talk about. Just like if you deep in a sport, like say football, that's all you know. So that's all they'll talk about when they get spare time. And Sam, but they have the world, so they speak things of the world.
Yeah. And then I was going to show that we have Yehovah Shemesh, right? So we always speak of Yahweh Hashem
Yahweh. We always speak about Yahweh Hashem.
That's why they will continuously hate us. Because we speak nothing else except the scriptures. You understand? We speak nothing else concerning the scriptures. You understand? Even the jokes and things we make with each other. The scriptures coming out. You understand?
We will have vibes
on the scriptures. You understand?
Always keeping your Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Hashem.
Exactly.
Yeah,
in 1 John 2:15,
say love not
the world.
Say love not the world. Love this world, but if we have in this world, we should love it. Or what to love?
As you see, this wicked kingdom.
Exactly.
You know, as I always say, like if the world is given to the hands of the wicked, right? Would the wicked do anything good?
At all.
So why can love you?
Because this place is wicked, full of our wickedness.
And just keep in mind, this complaint is saying the earth is given into the hands
of the wicked.
So there's nothing good out there for us. That's why our spirit is always in mourning.
So he
wasn't lamenting.
You see, I meditate there too.
Yeah.
Because the things you see now wrong is actually real bullshit.
Can.
You know, it's not a good sight to see. When you wake up every day and you just see evil in front of you. The first thing you wake up in the morning, just evil.
Yeah.
You
know? Because if you're in the spirit, right, you'll know or you will be vexed about everything in this world. Okay. You wouldn't be comfortable because only wickedness.
Yeah.
You understand? Well, I'll finish it too, sir.
He said, the 1 John 2:15, he said, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
Love of the Father not in him, if he loves this world. Because he can't be a friend of this world, and be a friend of the Most High. Can't be a man.
Can.
So the Lord is not a man. Can't go hand in hand.
Yes, so, as I was saying, you have to hate what the Most High hate, because he do hate. And you know what, if you watch this video and you say the Most High do hate, then you deny all the scriptures that we actually bring out. Because we prove, you know, we prove. I'm sure you through the scriptures that yes, the Most High do hate. Come on, the Malachi 1:3. So if we are to hate what the Most High hate, it's plain out, we have to hate this person as well. Come on, Malachi 1:3. Yeah, really.
This is Malachi chapter 1:3, right? He said, and I hated Esau.
Man, straight away, you must hate the white man straight away. We hate him as well.
God.
We can't love him. If you love that man for all he do, And what he's still doing in here, a wicked fucking nigga, boy.
Yeah, just like them, yeah, that's. You'll die just like them, same fucking way.
Give me Romans 9:13.
No, before you say that, right? Yeah. Because even yesterday, me and brother was talking, right? I mean, it's what Israelites out here, I mean, there's nothing you treat, right? But they love the white man.
Yeah.
Yesterday, we talking about that, they love the white man.
So until some
and,
of them.
And what, so the, what they're quick to say, right? Is that. We ask the brother everything the white man should pay, the so-called white man should pay, for the things they did to our forefathers, right?
No, I answer that.
Right? And we tell Yak. He say whatever any past is the past.
See the past is the past, the white man never do anything to him.
See, you understand?
Because you know what is going on? If it was now, when I was asking you, I did not get lynched and whip on the back, he'd have said different then.
And that
you know how you call that? And chain slave, not
Lekas.
Lekas. Because they just forget what we forefathers went through.
That's right.
Like them just forget that. Because that would, and then to them, the other houses teaching them, man. To love everybody and forgive them.
You know what? If one day you could pull out a scripture from the Bible that say, love everybody and forgive everybody, I pay you. I pay.
Hey,
you play now.
That just like if you ask them to bring out a scripture, we're saying, they don't like to say, marriage before sex.
Yeah.
That just like if you ask them.
Yeah. And the laws? Romans
9, verse 13.
So, you know why the old, you say here, you saw, in the new?
Same thing.
Yes, which is not.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved.
You know, man, I thought we say change.
But Esau have I hated.
You know what? The third child of Israel, Jacob, the most I love. And Esau, he hate. So if he loved the third child and he hate Esau, we gotta hate Esau as well.
Gone.
We can't love Esau. We supposed to love him. You know what? Even Mosai hate him, he hate him. We hate him as well. And that the thing, all the outside their feelings are, is everything outside them is really easy. The white man watching all those fucking slaves still. Right now they're dying every day because of them. With all how you feel, your people get the guns.
The low like all
the simple Negroes are not mind to get no guns. Is Esau giving all that?
They funded them.
That way? You see you change that?
Yeah. It's Malachi chapter 3 verse 6.
Yeah.
He said, I am the Most High.
Yeah.
I change not.
He what?
I change not.
He's the Most High, he don't change. So if he hate Esau, straight out, he hate him forever. Uh-huh. He changed not. I don't matter how these pastors want to put it, or how they want to say it, he changed not. He changed not. You can't go and have no presidential debate with the Most High and say, the Most High, I forgive them. Nah. He say he changed not. And if he hate them, he all hate them, and he knew, he hate them forever.
See, for I am the Most High, I change not.
Yeah.
Right? Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed.
Yeah. Even so, he changed not because he loved Jacob. So if you say he changed not, you keep on loving the 12 tribes.
Yeah.
You know? That way you say he changed not. That way you say Jacob won't be consumed. He will still be there. Same way you hate Esau, it's the same way you love Jacob. So, you know, that's a short little random topic. Yes, the Most High do hate, and yes, we're supposed to hate the things that the Most High hate.
Can.
You know? So, first, I'm going to give our praises to the Most High. Yahweh, Vashem, Yahushai. You know, again, double honesty, I love the rule well.
Can.
And salutation to the brothers that are outside there pushing the word in truth and sincerity.
Can.
That are going outside there, you know, preaching the downfall of this wicked kingdom. We're not upholding it, we just preaching the downfall of it, because this place is wicked.
Come.
So, you know, until then, we say Shalom.
Breathe.